And today it's Nylea, God of the Hunt, versus Animar, Soul of Element. Oh, yeah, she's already got in the hand. Have you already done your mulligan as well?
Yes. So do we start at 20 or 40, since we're not
40, yeah. Oh, still 40. Oh, okay. This might not be so hot.
Let's use some hot counters.
Yeah, we can use yours. They might not show up all that well, though. Here. Just because of the lack of contrast.
Yeah. I'm just used to that.
Fair enough. Definitely fair enough.
Alright.
And you can see the screen, so to see who goes first. Let's play poker. Let's ignore whatever this one lands on. It's a four. Okay. So, just a pair of fives. Can you beat? Yeah, I'm sure you can beat a pair of fives.
Okay.
You already have a pair of fives anyway.
I got a four.
Okay, so we tied.
Yeah. Pair of fives.
Yeah, that's it. Pair of fives. This is exactly what I got last time. We are recording.
It looks like you go first.
Okay, that'll do it. I will take it. Alright. So, because it's one-on-one, I don't draw the first time. So, would it foot hills? Oh, I'll actually put my deck over here. So it's a little, it's on the way for the camera just a bit. I'll go to 39. Get out of the breeding pool. And comes intact. Pass the turn.
Alright. Lay a land for turn.
That'll do it. Oh, geez, I'm so slow.
Faster.
Well, I'm trying not to look, but
Green Mage is doing this there.
Oh, no
starting
Mystic,
really
no Lanor Elves. Yeah.
I'm such a big creature deck that.
Fair enough.
I don't have many.
At least when you hit the late game, that means you're just going to be drawing bombs. Whereas in this deck, not exactly.
Yep. Or if I get that really lucky mana ramp at the beginning.
Alright, pass turn. Rupture Spire. That's it. That's all I got.
Attack two.
Mm-hmm.
Play Cream of the Cross. Whenever a creature comes into play, under my control, I may look at the top X cards where X is the creature's power.
Okay. So you get to set up your draw a little bit.
Basically, I get to choose one to go on top and the rest go on the bottom.
Fair enough.
And I pass turn.
Yes, Roy told us everything.
Hinterland Harbor. Animar. Pass turn.
Only I had gone first. Three hollow gemstones.
Okay, fair
gemstone.
Enough.
Gemstone.
I gotta pick a color every turn.
Pick a color every turn, pass turn. Before you draw.
Yeah, I'm thinking. Just hearing that.
Yeah.
Roy also
great. Wait a minute. It doesn't matter for this turn, but Reclamation Sage. Trigger.
Yay.
Well, that was a top deck. I'll let you know. Destroys an artifact or yeah. Yeah.
Oh, Josh, I need one more thing. Ten more powers.
I need all of the things. Rugged Highlands. And a life. Swing two.
I take two.
Last turn. Animar is not exactly popping off this game. I got slowed down just a touch.
Hmm. 3 for Dungrip Elder. He comes in as a 4-4.
Nice. Hexproof, no, power toughness equal number forest.
Yep.
I used to run that in my monogreen blouses deck.
I got the pretty art for it.
Very nice.
It's pretty as dumb to me.
Yep.
Jeez.
That mouth. Oh, and by the way, cream trigger?
Oh yeah, cream trigger. Let's see what I'm going to draw next.
Hey, I'm the one that's 20 ounces in.
Okay.
All right. Jeez, Dak, come on.
Now blink it.
Void Wielder, trigger, mm-hmm. Bounce Reclamation Sage. Sage, destroy cream.
How do you have enough for him?
Void Wielder is made cheaper off of Animar.
Yeah, that's right. Colorless. So Cream's crop's gone, sadly.
I don't want you getting that advantage, that card advantage.
Oh, so much fun with Lurking Predators.
I believe you. Not attacking now, pass turn.
Okay.
Seems like a bad idea. Mono green, so the first line of his text is just... its text is just dead. Yeah, it's...
3. Mana Gorger.
Oh god, that thing's gonna get huge, this game.
Yep.
That will be ridiculous, this game.
And... I'll pass turn.
Okay. I don't know why I feel the need to do that, but apparently I did. The little thing.
Yeah.
It's just a habit.
At least you don't have a foot pressing up into your abdomen right now.
No, I don't. Elder Scale Worm? That's one. Gets its two counters. Vivid Crag gets two counters. Pass turn. So until you kill the creature, which you're mono green, so.
Yeah, I run them in my deck, so.
Yeah, I believe you. Alright, it's a 6/6. A little too little.
Tap 6 mana.
Oh god. Why? Whenever an opponent casts a spell, reveal the top card. Yep. If it's a creature card, put it on the battlefield. This is where things get so much silly.
Yep. Lurking Predators is a very, very nice card.
You mentioned it earlier, I'll so I figured, you, I figured you had it.
I actually just top decked it.
That'll do. Ooh. Well, this is a awful hand.
I just like playing Cream of Crops and Lurking Predators together.
That's visible, yeah. Alright, guess what's happening to me? Oh, pass turn.
Oh.
Yeah, I know.
No free creatures?
I hit a landmark. Let's see.
Alright, who's ready for the last game? Really?
Tap 6.
I've heard that part.
Vigor.
Yep. If damage would be dealt to a creature you control other than Vigor, prevent that damage by +1/+1 power for each one damage prevented this way. Yep.
I'm gonna put my enchantment down there.
Fair enough.
I cast the spell so this gets bigger.
And it does.
I can find the 3. And I'll pass turn.
Alright. It's another land.
Woohoo!
Pass turn. That's what's happening. That's what's going on.
Look, I got a Dryad Arbiter.
Okay, enough of that.
Yeah. Sadly, it does not make my Dunker of Elder bigger.
It is still a forest.
It is?
Forest Dryad, yeah.
Let's bump that up to 7, though.
Doesn't make the Mana Gorger bigger. Wasn't cast.
No.
Creatures that aren't cast.
5. Attack 5. Play Frailes.
Hi, Frailes. Well, I have no artifacts or enchantments.
But I can plus 2 or make a 1/1 mana dweeb.
Seems good, mana dweeb, yeah. Seems pretty good. Does she have a patch?
She does have a patch over her eye.
I don't know how I didn't notice that. I think I always thought it was a shadow or something.
So she's at 5.
Right, with a Llanowar dweeb out.
I got a dweeb, sorry. I'm just trying to stay within the confines.
Sure, sure.
I put my dweeb.
You can always consult the screen if need be.
I put my dweeb above my planeswalker so I know what it is.
Fair enough.
And I'll pass turn.
Top decks of glory. Or not. That's just how this game is going for me. Pass turn.
I'm just waiting for my creatures to get big enough. But...
yeah, that'll do it.
Land!
Well, your land block is helping.
1, 2, 3, and 4.
Oh boy.
4.
Nylea. Yeah, she's a thing.
He gets a plus 1 counter. So all my creatures, except for Nylea, have trample. I will plus 2.
Alright.
I'll make another 1/1 dweeb. I can see my... there we go.
Here's a dweeb.
I got 2 dweebs now. Go to combat phase, actually.
Sure. Alright.
And swing an 8/8 at you. Triple.
Take 8.
And pass turn.
Oh my god. I need a shuffle. Oh my god. All these lands. Nope, that was not going well for me. Still should have waited until the end of your turn.
I'll say, technically,
you can
lose.
Be taking your turn. You can be taking your turn. Yeah, you're right. You can be taking your turn while I'm doing this.
Okay.
Because I'm passing turn after this. Yeah, I think it's the case that I didn't shuffle well enough after the last game. Perhaps it was because I was rushed. We just finished the game prior to this.
Yeah. Land for turn.
Okay.
Now I'm getting a mana pocket. I'm actually going to neg 6 Frailes.
Yep. Draw yourself out of your land pocket. Makes
hopefully
good sense. I'm not putting any pressure on you, so you might as well.
So I draw 4.
Okay.
6,
equal the number
actually
of creatures you control. Green creatures, right?
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4...
5,
yeah,
6.
Yeah, 5, 6. You're not a creature. Okay, yeah.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Have I played my land for turn yet? 6, 7, 8, 9. I have, sadly. Well, I could tell because Dungrove, I hadn't changed Dungrove yet. Oh well.
Holy shit, we won that?
Have you played a land every turn so far?
Yes, okay. I believe so.
I'm at 10 lands, so you may not have played a land yet. I've played a land every turn.
I might have missed a turn.
Maybe.
I will use the two dweebs as mana.
Schwick.
Yep. 3 and 4.
Jay, you all about done?
Play Oracle.
Honestly, I don't think so. I hit a land pocket. Actually, she has two.
And then I will play Mythos.
Hey. Never mind, she's about to win.
And float 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 mana.
All right, 4 still floating. That's a big one.
Sir,
okay. I think you're formidable. Let me count. Yeah.
And I played 3 more spells, so he's up to 8. And 2, 9, okay.
Thank you, Elder Scale Worm. You are a boss.
Soon it will be gone, though. I will swing 9, 8.
Why'd you hit me in the vagina for, bro?
I'm sorry, man. You've been cut.
Put me at 15.
And I'll pass turn.
Oh my god.
Really? He's still in the mana pocket?
We're still in the mana pocket. Pass turn.
Okay.
Thank you, based Elder Scale.
My lurking predators isn't working well. Because.
Okay.
Two lands per turn.
Fair enough.
Makes them 11.
Oh, right. I had an invention one time I thought would be hit.
That's gonna be stank.
I had an invention one time I thought would be making money until I tried to prototype out. Corduroy
time. God, I heard. 5, 6.
March.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Pathbreaker.
It makes me remember you. When it attacks, creatures you control gain trample and get plus X until end of turn, where X is 11, I think? The greatest power among... Yeah, which...
Power among my things? Which it could be a 25-25.
Or bigger.
Yeah.
Honestly, at this point, it could be any arbitrarily high number, and it either doesn't matter or doesn't matter.
I will go ahead and plus
sure.
to her just because.
We want to get that back online. Draw our sets out. Makes good sense.
And then. Just because, I will swing 11 plus 9 is 20.
I'm at 7.
You're at 7. I pass turn to you then.
We're at that stage in the game.
Yep.
Okay, so I have something I can do. I know, right? Primordial Sage?
I'll tuck Nissa.
Okay. Fair enough. An Oracle can't even pick it up either. You'll draw it before she gets a chance. Well, Primordial Sage can get me out of this, so maybe I'll draw out. Maybe. Not like that. I mean... Stomping Ground? Still lands. Pass turn. Obviously still lands. Gee, I wonder what these two cards in my hand happen to be.
You're ugly as fuck, dude.
He's so polite. Okay.
First land for turn.
Yeah.
Look! I have a creature on top!
Ta-da!
Second land for turn.
Now, where's Leatherback Bailiff? Or not Leatherback, what's the stampeding...
Thunderfoot Bailiff.
Well, what's the one that lets you play creatures off the top?
Oracle Moldav?
Oh, that's lands.
Oh, creatures.
I have it in my deck, I just can't remember its name.
I know what you're talking about, I don't know how
I think I have it in here, but I can't remember.
Garrick Sword.
Garruk Sword.
Garruk Sword.
Garruk Sword, yep. Okay, there we go then. Very nice,
plus
man.
Plus 1? I mean, plus 2?
We're almost there again. Still no artifacts or enchantments on my side. You could destroy the predators, but
I pass turn because there's no point in swinging.
Are you a goat? You
he
are
a goat. He is a goat.
You know what that's an acronym for? Greatest of all time.
Never heard that one.
Okay, speaking of Garuk's horde, I'll cast said horde.
8, 9, I missed that trigger last time, but that goes onto the field.
Okay, now I can play out this.
Oh my gosh, that's the perfect combo.
When it attacks. Yeah, it kind of is, just a lot. Do I do this now or do I wait? I do this now. Better the devil you know than the devil, or better the devil, yeah. Play wild canter off the top, trigger, and you're gonna get the wild beastmaster out.
And I
get a
counter.
Merfolk looter. Trigger.
Courser. Trigger.
Draw the card off the top. Oh, you God, Jay, what have you been missing? It's okay, it's fine, it's fine.
And I missed
I was
two
so glad.
On him.
Fair
to,
enough. I was so glad that I was drawing out that I didn't pay attention to my commander. That's what I get, I guess.
Hello.
Fortune Hydra.
Milwaukee's best.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, I wasn't kidding when I said I'm a few ounces in. I actually did not mean to. Well, I'll tell you that in a bit. So, Merfolk Looter's out. Oh, it's Axis of Awesome. The group that does the four chord song. Play a Griff Vanguard. When it's the battlefield, draw a card. Yeah.
To my graveyard.
I'll do it. So, stack the Primordial Sage trigger comes first. You get to see Kiki Tiki on the top. And then the Griff Vanguard trigger. And you get to see Wall of Roots on the top. Yeah. Play the Wall of Roots. You know what? I keep forgetting them. I don't really have any excuse at this point.
Temp going to the bottom.
Jay, come on. Stop missing those triggers. You have no excuse.
Rogue's Passage on top.
Red? Oh, it's not enough. I still have to play it off the top, I think. Yeah, I still have to. If damage... Oh, man. If damage would be dealt. Which means...
So, you cast that?
I'm casting it, yes. And I'm dividing... Well, first, get the draw trigger off Primordial Sage. It's Tenderwall. Omen Speaker. I'm sure people are going to note all the misplays I've made here. I need... Okay. Time to get serious.
Alright, y'all don't
ready
start another game.
Go. No, we're not going to. This is our last one.
They're talking about the big group in there.
Oh, okay. So, Burgard and Hillkite has entered the battlefield, and really, the only real target here is you, because 5 isn't enough to kill Vigor, and if I target anything else, they just get countered, because this is just damage. So, I'm going to deal 5 to you.
Okay. I can find 13 now. There we go. At one time you look for that one number and it does not want to show up.
I feel you. Play the Omen Speaker off the top.
I get a Tornado Elemental which does 6 damage to all flying creatures as it enters the battlefield.
Okay. Bogard and Hellkite and Griff Vanguard are dead. Draw off of the Primordial Sage trigger.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're going to scry 2. I accidentally saw 2, but whatever, because I'm about to scry them anyway.
This is amazing.
This is, isn't it? Welcome to the wonderful world of me doing whatever the hell I'm doing. You know what I've been missing?
Still.
There's no better time than the present. And for the most part, this hasn't mattered. Because everything's so light on mana, once you get past a certain point, it doesn't matter. There are some cards, however, that need it to be much higher than it is right now.
Mm-hmm.
So, oh, by the way, we're scrying still. probably right now. I think I actually want both of these. I think so. This will help. Okay, so the top card is a Rattleclaw Mystic, which I can morph, because morphing is free. There's one. Draw a card off Primordial Sage. Off the top, it's a Guild Gate.
So the morph, I tuck Burgeoning.
Yeah.
And this goes up 16.
That'll do.
My top card is a Wolfish Silverheart. Woohoo!
I need to save you for right now. Augury Owl, trigger.
Wolfish Silverheart, which will soul bound with Mosswort Bridge. Mosswort Bridge.
Oh god. Plus four, plus four. So it could be a 29-29. That's always fun.
I can actually activate that ability more than once so I can make it as big as I want.
I believe you. I do. Alright, so we're going to put one on top, two on bottom. We're going to reveal Wood Elves. We're getting to that stage, I guess.
No artifacts or enchantments still?
No, not yet. Wood Elves, trigger, draw a card. It's Wall of Blossoms.
Swiftfoot going on bottom.
I guess there's no point in revealing this one. It is a Voyaging Satyr, but the Wood Elves is coming in and getting me. Probably didn't need to do that. Probably should have done Wall of Roots. But I'm getting a forest, and unfortunately, because Tropical Island, Taiga, Stomping Ground, and Breeding Pool are all out already, that means I have to get a basic forest, because I don't have the battle lands, the tango lands, takes two to tango. I don't have those in here. So I'm getting a basic forest and putting it into play. Does not say it comes untapped. And then we'll shuffle. Yeah, this is Animar. Welcome to Animar. Check my morph again. I wonder what that is. Okay. Actually, that is probably worth doing. I think now is the time if I'm going to. Would you like to cut? There's no room. I put it on Mosswort, no disrespect, but there's no room at this point.
He's big enough, he can hold it.
Yeah, that he can. Okay, so the top card is Kozilek.
You haven't killed him?
No, I've been making misplays, you see. Most especially missing animal
Once
triggers.
I can get rid of that, I'll kill him.
Rattleclaw, trigger.
Forgotten Ancient.
Well, this isn't a cast trigger.
Oh.
Yeah. This is just it morphing. So now I have one of each color floating.
I tried slowing down with Hollow Gemstone, but he got...
Yeah. Long story very short.
That one.
Animar is actually significantly bigger than he is. It's just I've been missing his triggers because I've been focusing so much on not misplaying this part that I've been missing Animar triggers. You understand how that works. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So I think the correct way to do this here is I'm going to start by spending the green. Now the only mana left is one of each color. I'm going to spend the green on a Wall of Blossoms, which is going to give me a draw trigger.
I get Forgotten Ancient.
From Primordial, followed by a draw trigger from Wall of Blossoms.
That goes up to 19, so it's a 20-20.
That it is. And Soul of the Harvest is on top?
Yes.
We're going to morph the Echo Tracer. Draw trigger off Primordial Sage. Good. Okay, so that's the top. See, Grunk's Horde is letting me play creatures off the top. So right now it's currently blue-red in my pool. If I do this... I'm not killing you this turn, I guarantee, but... Let's not forget. Never forget. I know. This is terrible. Even after I say it, I still forget to do it.
Mm-hmm.
You know that's... Okay, so, spend green on Wall of Roots. I'm going to turn it upside down to represent that I've spent the green this turn. It is now a -1/4. I know, he must be walking way out of just like, no way, Jay. You can't be this bad. Borderland Ranger.
Right, cast trigger. Tots.
It's a fierce impact. Oh, it's a fierce impact. Oh.
This is 21 now.
Getting a basic land. I'm glad that you're still keeping up with this. That's super respectful. I'm getting an island, adding it to hand. That is my hand.
I swear you might deck out before this game is over.
Maybe. All your non-creatures are gonna be at the bottom by the time this game is over.
I have a couple of creatures in there that shuffle my graveyard back.
Fair enough. Good old Eldrazi. Classics, staples, all that jazz. Alright, so we still have blue-red floating. Top card is, I forgot, the reason that I'm putting it over here is so that they can see what's on top. Silverglade Elemental, but I have no green floating right now.
Hey, this helps me go through my deck to find something to kill Elderscale.
That it does. And that's a little bit worrisome. A little bit. Free cast Kozilek.
Tap this forest.
Alright, one. Oh, so this is the Primordial Sage draw. And then one, two, three, four.
With Nithus on the table, I have enough, more than enough mana.
Blightsteel Colossus.
Colonial. Twin Grove, so I get a copy of that, actually.
Yeah.
And I actually... Oh.
Yeah. We're getting to that part.
I get to draw, too.
Oh, this is Disturbed that's doing the Sound of Silence, right? Yeah. Oh, it's when it enters. Yes, so you do get to draw.
But you get to see what I draw because of Oracle.
Because, yeah. That's why I've been doing this every time. I really, really dig this song. This is a...
Oh, that's a nice card. Concordance Crossroads. I don't think either of us need that, though. Oh, actually, sorry.
And yes, you're right, we don't.
I only get to draw one because it has to be a non-token creature, and one is a token because it's a copy of Colonial Twin Grove, which they are both a 13-13... because they equal to the power of forest.
Sack Wild Canter for green. Play the aforementioned Silverglade Elemental. Draw. Yeah, you get your trigger. Elvish Piper.
I will draw.
Concordant Crossroad, yeah.
Top card.
Alright, so Grogil Gates in hand. The, Silverglade is down here. I don't know why I put it down with my land. It's because it's making land, so I'm sure that was something subconscious. The top card is Burnished Heart, but it doesn't matter. I'm getting a forest, so I'm getting a basic forest, and it's not coming in tapped, because fuck that.
I'm gonna start.
This is one turn, guys!
Start condensing sense.
Okay, there is actually an endgame here, I promise. Okay. So the red. I have red blue still floating with green on the table. Okay, let me think.
Yeah.
Your three are the most important at this point. Okay. And then there's...
So it's Courser. I haven't been getting my life from my Courser.
Your life is practically infinity at this point.
I haven't been... Why have I not been putting counters on Forgotten Nature?
Okay, so at this point, Animar might as well be infinity. This is as high as he needs to go for any... I mean, unless he's infinite. So, an arbitrarily high number at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's not really true. You could attack with a bunch of creatures and he could block, but
yeah.
No creatures will get any cheaper based on how many counters he has right now, is perhaps the better way of putting it.
Yep.
Okay, so this turn goes a little bit differently if I have a certain card in my deck, which I don't have. Do you have Polymeron? The untapped 7 land creature from Urza block? That needs to be in this deck, and I don't have it. So otherwise, that gets a little bit sillier. But since I don't, and yes, this is still my turn. This is all one big fucking turn. So give me a second to think. One, two, three.
Completely forgotten ancient.
There's red, blue floating. I can spend the blue on. Let me leave me. You don't have haste, so I can't use you right now. I've already played my land this turn. I don't think I can kill you quite. Oh, wait a minute. I don't have to kill you quite yet. This is... No, I do. That's silly. That doesn't really work. Annihilator 4 is going to do jack all to you right now. Technical term, jack all. You don't have haste. Okay, so...
Most of the stuff you play is...
1, 2, 3, 4. And then... need one more. Okay, so I think that's the right way. That's the right play. We're going to try this. We're going to try it. Tenderwall, trigger
what?
From Primordial Sage.
Two.
The top card.
Tap a forest.
Sack. Oh, God. Okay, Tenderwall. Sacrifice for red. Spin the red that's floating for Kiki Jiki. By the way, I'm going to flip one around. Draw. I swear to God, if
so
you were on the
two,
top. Nope, Alchemist Apprentice is on the top.
Engulfing Slagworm, I draw.
Yeah.
And the top card is an Arbor Colossus.
Let me look through my hand of 88 cards. Okay. So the problem is that I don't have Deceiver Exarch, Pestermite, or Zealous Conscript out on the field right now. So Kiki Jiki can tap, but if I do that, then I forfeit the ability to kill you with Splinter Twin this turn.
It's not Splinter Twin, it's Kiki Jiki.
Well, yeah, okay, fair. You're right. That combo, that particular combo. I can get another green if I pull out Silverglade. Yeah, either of these two will get me another forest. And as we've seen, I only have basic forest left. In fact, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so that gives you something that's in my hand. But I think I want to play... I have blue left in the pool, and do I play that? I think I have to get... I'm going to give myself another draw step by doing this. So I'm going to put in a copy of Silverglade.
So you just cast that?
I just cast... It has haste.
Okay. I was just making sure you cast it so I get my triggers.
Yeah. So when it enters the battlefield, get a forest. I'm going to give myself basically another draw here.
Arbor Colossus, draw.
Yeah.
There's my Thunderfoot Baloth.
Hi, Thunderfoot.
Thunderfoot.
Wild Ravager on top.
Let's make it 32 by the time I'm done. Yeah, let me know when you see something. Looking through the trade binder.
I don't know how, but I'm still going. This is one turn.
Okay.
Alright, I'm gonna let you lock them up.
Okay.
Greening Ignis.
Have a good night, boss.
Alright.
Blue is still floating. Blue is the only one that's still floating.
Sorry about that.
So. Yes, I am sorry, dude. I really am. I'm just. So there's a copy of Silverglade. Dreamstalker is the blue. I'm gonna. So you get your Nessun Ravager.
On the cast, no.
It's going to return Kozilek to hand. I'll get the draw from the cast. And there's Birds of Paradise.
And since you are the only one here,
yeah.
Do you pay tribute?
You can have a 12-12.
Okay.
And then I'll free cast Kozilek and draw 5 cards, 1 from Sage. And then 1... Oh, you troll!
6.
Oh!
Five. Siege Behemoth.
Wait a minute. I can do stuff here. I can do stuff here! Because Phyrexian Metamorph is in my hand. So, because Phyrexian Metamorph is out, I've already played a land. Damn it! Now, this would be an instance where having the blue-green... There's not a blue-green Tango land yet, because those are enemy colors. Never mind. That wouldn't help. I need a it needs to be a forest that also is, you know, blue. But I already have Trop and Breeding Pool out, so the only other choice would be the Tango land that still hasn't been printed yet. But will be. So let's see. Still fucking going. Free cast Ulamog. Trigger.
I'm just stopped drawing by this point.
Yeah. Ulamog will destroy... Does it matter? I know, right? Yeah, this is a silly way to go about it. Okay. I think Lurking Predators is what I destroy. It's really, really late to do it, but Lurking Predators is what I'm destroying with Ulamog's cast trigger.
Yeah, it's a permanent, right?
It is a permanent. Destroy target permanent. And you have something you can... Of course you have something you can do. I've only given you 88 cards to work with.
I'll let it be destroyed.
There is still something I can do from this spot. So we're going to play off the top. We're going to free cast. Ulamog's Crusher. Draw.
Eight.
Raven's Familiar. Not Raven's. Okay. I think we're done at this point. We're not done. Of course we're not done. This is me we're talking about. Oh, wait a minute. Let me read the text on Elderscale Worm. As long as you have 7 or more life, so I can't... free cast Phyrexian Metamorph, because if I do, I go below 7, and then you kill me, because Elderscale won't protect me if I'm lower than 7. So, given that, yeah, it's in the last paragraph. I have no mana floating right now. I don't think I have any way to make mana right now.
Oh, well, yeah, you're right.
This turn plays out a little differently if I hadn't missed those Animar triggers earlier. Animar should be much, much, much bigger, but at this point it's just arbitrarily large. Mm-hmm. It doesn't really matter. So, keeping you, I know, right? Keeping you, and then one more, and then fuck all the rest of these. Cody, I am sorry. I'm almost done, I swear.
I don't mind.
Well, I'll wait. I'll do this when she's taking her turn. How many cards are in your hand right now? Yes.
Five.
$5 foot. Oh no. Oh my goodness. This is dumb. Okay.
Okay. So it's officially my turn.
Yes, it is officially your turn.
I draw a myriad landscape.
Yes. Now we can't play them off the top, at least. Lurking Predators being gone and whatnot. On the other hand, Nykthos cast for all of the mana.
All my devotion?
I swear, if you have a Genesis Wave in there. If you have a Genesis Wave.
I know.
Cody, tell me, does she have a Genesis? No. Fighting dirty. Okay, so you know that I have the kill in hand. You have to kill me this turn. I have a Deceiver Exarch in hand with Kiki Jiki out, so... I also have a Zealous Conscripts in hand, so
Thunderfoot Bela.
You have to kill me this turn. Those two cards you saw, actually, I'm pretty sure you saw, I know you saw the Exarch, I'm pretty sure you saw the Conscript, so...
I know how she could win.
Yeah, I know she can, it's just, I don't know what she has in her hand.
Well, it's less about winning this turn and more about surviving the next turn.
Fair enough. Okay, fair enough. That'll do it.
I will go ahead and draw since...
Yeah?
That entered.
Might as well.
Ooh, that's nice too. These are both 15-15s as well. So I have 15 forest.
So what is Animar's actual... According to this, what is Animar's actual pound? You were on the field. You were morphed. You were on the field. You were on the field. Everything else came out this turn, I think. No, Primordial Sage. So... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 from whatever you bounced. I think there ought to be more than 16 counters, but that's as much as I'm counting right now.
Can I see your Eldrazi real quick?
Was Rattleclaw... Oh, wait.
That
17. Yeah, which Eldrazi?
The ones on the field.
There's only three Eldrazi in here.
Here's a goblin guy.
May I see all your artifacts?
Oh, yeah. So Blightsteel's indestructible, though. But yes, it has Infect and Silliness. Infect, Trample, Indestructible... Can't be reanimated very easily.
I'm trying to figure out what he sees.
What I see?
Mm-hmm.
What do I see? Or
no, what he sees.
Oh, okay. That's a... Yeah, that's a good question. So, if I make infinite creatures, vigor doesn't matter. I'm trying to look to see what you have that saves you next turn. You might have something. I wouldn't doubt it. Or at the very least, something that kills a creature, but you're mono green.
Do you have flying creatures?
I do indeed. Do you want me to put my flyers together? All one of them, apparently? Never mind, just one flyer.
Do you want me to do
that? Augury Owl is my one flyer.
Oh!
I'm going to have a bit more...
I can still kill him with commander damage, even with Elder Scale.
I had to finish swallowing. That's true, you can. Damage that would... it doesn't prevent damage. It's just damage that would reduce your life total to less than 7. Oh my god. Oh my god. It's true. It's true!
28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43.
No!
I float 43 green mana.
Yeah, you do.
Before you start doing anything, I would like to point out that...
That's what I'm using.
Yeah, Kamal is actually more effective.
Yeah.
Mana is used more effectively on him.
So
43, so...
45.
40 divided by 5 is 8. So all your creatures get 8 times 3, plus 24, plus 24. All your creatures have plus 24, plus 24, with 3
and
mana
trample.
Floating. And trample.
And plus 2, plus 2, so everything technically has plus 5, plus 5 now.
Plus 26, plus 26.
Yeah, there we go.
Yes.
That's the math. And
well,
then,
she activated it 9 times.
45 divided by 5 is 9.
That's amazing.
And
can I just say, that's amazing.
Siege Behemoth, as long as he's attacking, all my attacking creatures do combat damage as though not being blocked.
Which only matters for Nylea, but which matters for Nylea. Okay, so this is my field. I comboed off last turn, but couldn't quite kill her. I was looking for that one, either blue mana or red mana for Zealous Conscript or Deceiver Exarch, and I couldn't quite finish her. I ran out of mana first.
So over 30 commander damage.
Ta-da! Look at that! Just, let me admire this. This is art. This is art! That was amazing.
I may not have been able to destroy creatures, but...
Okay, so if my interpretation of Elder Scale Worm is true, then as long as I have 7 or more life damage that would reduce my life total to less than 7, but I still take the commander damage.
The commander damage.
Yeah.
Okay, so in other words, yes. That's... Okay, so but you only have Oh, it doesn't. Okay, so if you're only swinging with you...
I'm swinging with these two because he has to be attacking.
Okay, so I might actually be able to survive this. Yeah, whatever. Okay, so this is plus 26, plus 26, so it's a 32.
Everything technically has plus 26, plus 26.
Oh, well, never mind, because it can't be... You can direct the damage to me even if it's blocked. So never
yes.
mind, I actually can't win this.
And he's hexproof, so you can't target him with...
Yeah.
Abilities.
I'm out of mana, so some neat little tricks might be Deceiver Exarch to tap it down or something like that.
That's still going on?
Well, no, not anymore.
Just killed him.
She just killed me. This, look at this! Look at this!
I only needed two creatures.
That you lost with Blightsteel Colossus on the field?
I lost with Blightsteel, Ulamog, Ulamog's Crusher, and Kozilek on the field. They didn't have haste, and I ran out of mana to Splinter Twin Killer. So, yeah.
I know. Looking at the Malky's best.
Okay.
Good game.
That was amazing. That was...
I'm
astounded.
I didn't even use my...
No, we're not talking about the folder either.
And Wild Beastmaster.
We'll just take this bag in the other room and dart it for you, okay?
I actually do think... And I don't take this the wrong way. I don't mean this rudely.
I'll take
at all.
That trap down card.
I do think that I could have won last turn, and here's the reason why I say that. If I had not been missing my Animar triggers, then it would have taken less time for me to free cast these guys, and as a result, I would have not had to spend mana earlier when I. No, that may not be true. That may not be true. What I'm saying is, I had to. Instead of free casting these earlier, I had to spend mana to build up more counters to free cast them later. And I may have had enough mana afterwards to cast the Deceiver Exarch and Splinter Twin Killer. Maybe not.
You don't need them.
I can see that when I do the video later. But that's what looks to be the case.
You still have your key?
Yeah. I don't know.
We both misplaced tonight.
Oh, yes.
How are you walking up, Jock?
Very much.
Those are mine now.
Well, I don't know. This is why I love this deck. It's a puzzle.
Yes.
Every time you try to go off like that, it's a puzzle. You have to try to figure it out. And maybe there's no answer, or maybe there's multiple answers, but...
Is it going to be these?
Oh, this is my favorite. And the deck isn't quite complete. Honestly, I was considering taking out the Splinter Twin combo for a few that helped me to normal combo some more, but I think...
And this
I think
one's
this
40.
Is just too good to not.
Oh, 40 bucks?
Yeah.
The downside of Kiki, the biggest downside is that he costs red, 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 and red is the color I make the...
You have no red in your deck.
I don't have very much, because most of what I'm doing to combo off is either blue or green, but Kiki Tiki is red, red, red.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, there's a number of ways I could go about good games. That was amazing. Mm-hmm. A number of ways I could go about doing this. I thought about the safer play.
Like a real man.
No, it's fine.
I know it. You heard
Lurking Predators. Definitely pulled it
Jay,
out.
We'll hold these in the other room and guard them for you.
Yeah, these are
The Milwaukee's best ice.
Yeah, we'll hold them in here for you. So you don't lose them.
Well, I mean, that's fair, but I'm done forever after that one. That was amazing. That was perfect.
But yes, we're stealing the beer.
Cody.
Jeez. This game. I don't even know what. Jeez.
I think that one's yours.
Yes. That Aetherize token. Wow. I'm gonna all night. I'm just gonna be like, wow. That happened. That happened, YouTube. That fucking happened. If you watched through my 10,000 minute turn, and you got to see that, congratulations, you win at life.
Switch on the ground, and the guy goes, switch?
I got to sit there and watch you do it. Like,
yeah,
luckily I had triggers to keep up with.
That's fair. That keeps you, like, mentally in the game.
Yeah.
Alright. See you later. Bye-bye.